let's take a look at Starter React. Starter React app is a scaffolding app I created that uses React and Webpack. You can view the source, or you can remix it and build upon it yourself.
Webpack is a module bundler, and it's able to pretty much bundle up any of your front-end assets that you might want to include on your web application. And so that can be your JavaScript, your CSS, some image assets. And it allows you to have a lot of fine-grained control over how you're actually bundling up all of those different assets to run on your application.
I'm going to edit my project. When you open a project on Glitch, it typically opens through a README file that explains what's going on in here. It's a code editor, so you have a sidebar here that lists all the files that are in the project. I'm going to show you a couple of them. Let's start out by looking at the package.json file that shows our dependencies for building a simple React app. Express is our middleware for Node because Glitch allows you to build full-stack apps and view the source even of the server-side files. We're using React and React DOM to create DOM elements, or document object model elements, on our page. And we're using something called JSX, which we need Webpack to load.
JSX is a language built around JavaScript that adds this notion of template tags, which it's basically function calls, but they're written in a style that looks like HTML. And this works really well with React's component model, where you write stuff that looks like HTML, but actually compiles down to like function calls that build your React components.
Here's our Webpack config that just lets the app know that we're going to be using the file extensions .js and .jsx. And it takes all the JavaScript files that we are building and bundles it into a single one that can be viewed on our index.html file. And I have a couple of components here that I've created for you.
Components are a collection of UI elements, whether it be a button, a paragraph, a link, and you can also pass in props to these components that can modify or change how they look or how they would behave.
You can see all in action by clicking the show button. When a user goes to your app, they're given index.html, and this is where we have a bundle of all of our React component and scripts, thanks to Webpack. And it's also where we declare what element we want our app to show up in. In this case, we have one with the ID main. Let's take a look at Hello World. Hello World is a component that returns a bunch of elements. I have a tag that just says Hello World. That's this blue here. And then I have a paragraph describing what the app is. And I have this unordered list tag. This isn't an HTML tag. This is calling another component that I had built in React, which shows here in unordered list.jsx. Unordered list takes an array prop called items and returns an unordered list HTML element with each item as a list item within it. So in Hello World or anywhere else in my app that I import unordered list and call it here, I have to give it that items prop. In this Hello World component, for example, the items attribute, I give the value dependencies array, which is what I declared up here on top of my code. And here is just an array of strings that I list the dependencies for my app. App.jsx is how React tells the app where to put that Hello World element. The cool thing about components is that once you write it, you can call it and have it in your page multiple times. In Hello World, I have two unordered lists, one that gives the dependencies array as a prop, and one that gives another array, components made, as a prop. So by making unordered list a component, I just have two lines of code here that show a whole unordered list of those items, instead of having to rewrite all this code over and over and over again within my app.
Components, elements, and props all work together in order to create the UI. And so components are concerned mostly with returning the HTML that you want to put on your page. Properties are the data that you can pass into those components in order to influence either behavior of the component or maybe even just the appearance of the component itself. And elements are essentially what you use in order to generate that HTML that the component returns in the first place.
In this video, we learned more about React and the programming concepts behind it, and we worked on an actual app, which you can go to at starter-react.glitch.me, and you can remix it and work on it yourself. In the next video, we're going to talk about routing and how we can use React Router to add pages to our app.